stored files at the Ministry of Land. That's where the files disappear. When there is a critical file that is needed, that's when the title deed is not there. And you cannot even trace how many lands are in, well, I mean, are current, that you cannot even find who the real owners are, because land officials have colluded with the cartels and have stolen the documents. The question, the fundamental question that perhaps we're going to ask as a country is, who is this that is going to do this lifestyle audit if the government themselves and the people who are senior in the government are the ones already accused of corruption? And I'm not saying all of them, but majority of the government and public servants have stolen money, and they've stolen money with the citizens. And so when you say that the government is going to do this, I'm wondering who is going to help do this lifestyle audit, because some of those people are the real thieves. They will be helping these people. We've had the likes of EACC now being sidelined by the DPP's office and DCI's office. Why are they being sidelined? Because it looks like they're not able to handle the task that has been given them, but simply because you go out there and there are many corrupt governors, there are many corrupt CECs in the counties, there are many corrupt parliamentarians, but they wouldn't go to them, because when an officer goes there to investigate, he gets 100 million and he goes home and he says, man, I don't think there is any corruption there, because he will never work for 100 million in 70 years. We've just seen what has happened in NYS2, where basically a chief investigator is involved in the whole fiasco of business with NYS. And so you're wondering, but which angel is coming to do this lifestyle audit? I think that's why parliamentarians, and you ask Honorable Kenyatta a very simple question that I needed answer. How do you oversight on behalf of the people? In my view, that is what perhaps we need to hear from Honorable Kenyatta more than anything else. How do they ensure that as parliamentarians, they are also raining on these people instead of just calling them when there is a whistleblower somewhere? I know they might say that we do not have an arm on investigative, an investigation arm of parliament, but really, they are members of this country. They are members.
They see what's happening.
They see what is happening. They know, but until something is mentioned, you don't hear them talk.
Can I reply to that? You say the jurisdiction of Parliament through two ways. Number one, either a matter of public interest that has been highlighted in the media, for instance, but number two, and most importantly, through the reports of the Auditor General, particularly for Public Accounts Committee and Public Investments Committee. So they're the one, of course, who will come through, they check your books. If they see an anomaly, they will come before the parliamentary committee, and then you'll be called upon to come and defend. Of course, surely, you cannot just summon a person who has no query, where you don't have any evidence of malfeasance. So therefore, you have to rely on a certain report. But there are instances, for instance, this NYS, where you may find the Auditor General was unable to uncover a problem. In such an instance, you therefore rely on two things, either a public outcry, like the instance case, or where you may get a whistleblower who may as well petition Parliament. You see, we have procedures of petitioning Parliament. Mm. You may petition, you may even ask a question. You may draw a question directly to a member of Parliament or through parliamentary procedures. Then Parliament then will get the jurisdiction. It will ask that question. And once that happens, then Parliament will proceed to ask questions.
Okay.
And I can tell you, we investigate so many things. You go to Parliament, you will find the day in, day out, there are so many matters that are being brought by Parliament which do not come in public limelight. Because, of course, press is the one that decides we are going to highlight this story, this one we think is of no use, that one we have no control over. But there are so many things that we investigate.
That you're oversighting. Yes. All right, and let me come to you, Weda. One of the other problems that we are facing because of corruption, and sometimes